you unmute it, Pat. We ready?
Hey, Coach, it's the commish with Raider Reaction again. Thank you for joining us on the day after. Appreciate it.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Do you want to start or do you want me to start? Because you know where we're going first, right?
Go ahead.
Okay, let's just jump right into it, man, like a fat man at a free buffet. We sat right here last night. Why didn't you come out after the game and immediately spill blood on the stage and fire Paul Gunther right in the post-game press conference? That is what your fan base wanted. They wanted to see blood immediately. Why did you have to wait and go back and release a statement later?
No, I'm not going to answer, you know, a million questions today. It's a very tough decision we made. Paul is a great friend and a great coach, and he's given a great effort here for 2.5 years. And it was a very tough circumstance with the COVID, players coming and going, all the injuries. We need a new voice right now. I think it'll help Paul in the long run, probably getting away from me, but certainly he's a great coach. We thank him for everything that he has done. But we need a new voice right now. I think we need a new energy. And with 3 games left, we're gonna let Rod Marinelli call the plays. He's experienced doing that. We have a good staff. We have a lot of young players, and we want to service those players the best way we can with a new voice, a new energy, and a guy that's had a lot of experience in some tough situations. And I'm really excited about our football team. We did some good things yesterday in spite of some of the things we didn't do well, but I'll answer any questions I can.
Ultimately, you are the head coach, and you were just hired a few seasons ago, and you brought all of these folks in, handpicked them, and sat right here and, you know, told us that this was the guy, that he was going to help resurrect the Raiders defense and, you know, return it to greatness. So do you think now, after a couple seasons of wasted time, that in the next 3 weeks you could put that together?
Well, it's a hard question right now. We, you know, Cleve Farrell comes out of the game, John Abram is in concussion protocol, Nick Morrow's in concussion protocol. You know, we're missing Damon Arnett, Jeff Heath. A lot of guys are unavailable right now. So we like our young team. I want to reiterate that. We do have some veteran players that we are excited about. We got to put it all together. And it goes on me right now to get that done. And at the end of the day, it's my responsibility.
Yes, we're well aware, Coach. You don't have to keep bringing up the injuries. Every team is dealing with injuries. Every team's dealing with COVID. It's part of being the head coach in the National Football League. It's just one of the things that you deal with. Other seem to be dealing with it a little better than currently your franchise is. How do you feel about turning this all around in the next 3 days and getting ready for the Sparklers on Thursday night?
You know, it's going to be tough. They got to go through the proper channels, and I'll have to update you on that as soon as possible. But right now we have a lot of players in question.
Are you concerned about having to play the Sparklers with your season on the line? Are you concerned if the fan base is going to turn on you if you lose a game to the Los Angeles Sparklers, a game this big to the 2020 season?
Different. They played very well yesterday, defensively especially. They intercepted Ryan 3 times, had a couple sacks, and Eckler is a guy that can catch it from anywhere on the field, in the slot, as a receiver, coming out of the backfield. And Justin Herbert is a guy we know firsthand can make all the plays. So we'll have our hands full again, and that's why we got to get back to work.
Now, when you brought Marinelli in to begin with, it kind of looked from the outside looking in that you were already looking to bring in Paul Gunther's replacement, and that ultimately ended up being what happened. Do you really have that much faith that Rod can turn this around in 3 weeks, completely backed in the corner with zero margin of error?
Well, I think he's one of the great teachers and great motivators and great people that I've met in this business. And he looks forward to adversity. You know, he thrives in it. I think he looks forward to these challenges, the building of this defense, putting it all together. And that's why we brought him here in the first place. It would certainly help if his soldiers got healthy up front, but he's got great experience and has a great amount of experience in situations like this.
So when you guys have had time, let's even say today, since now Rod is the guy and you've had time to sit down, look at the game tape and what you've put out there on the field over the last few weeks, what does he think? How does he even think that a turnaround is possible in 3 weeks?
Well, it's the same things you've been hearing, I'm sure, from Paul and the players. You know, we misfit some runs. Sometimes our force isn't where it needs to be. Sometimes we don't tackle well. Sometimes it's a play here, it's a play there. But we got to do everything better, honestly. And not just one kind of run, inside runs, outside runs, the run game. And with that said, you got to stop the play action pass, and you got to stop a lot of other things that have been problematic. So we got a lot of work to do, but we have good players here. We got a good staff. It is a very difficult night because I love Paul, and I'm going to miss him. But we need a new voice right now, and Marinelli's going to give it to us.
So you guys made a lot of moves, bringing guys in on the defensive side of the ball in free agency. You made a lot of moves in the draft. Everything was really pointed towards the defense, trying to fix that side of the ball. I mean, how do you feel about all of the misses that you have had on that side of the ball this season, and where the direction of the defensive side of the ball is currently going?
Well, look, it's been at every level, and I'm not here to make any excuses. You know, we got to play better. We got 3 games left, but you know, Kwiatkowski's had injuries. Littleton has had coronavirus. Now Nick Morrow has a concussion. John Abram's been in, he's been out. Damon Arnett has been out most of the year. Now Jeff Heath is out. LaMarcus Joyner's had the coronavirus. Obviously Carl Nassib and Malik Collins now is on IR. Hurst has had the coronavirus. We've had it at all 3 levels now. Farrell is hurt. So we have to do some damage control. We got to continue to coach and grind and stay positive and hope that Vic Beasley, Tack McKinley, some of these newcomers can step up and play key roles for us.
So after we talked last night and said here in the postgame press conference, you made no allusion to the fact that you're going to fire Paul Gunther, although the Raider Nation as a whole was collectively calling for his head. They wanted a public execution. What was it like to hear that so many around you wanted to see somebody so close to you terminated?
Yeah, it's really hard, you know, really hard, because I had a lot of respect for this guy, Paul Gunther, and he's a good friend of mine, always will be. It was very hard to do, but I really feel for the best interest of this team right now. We need a new voice. We need somebody that has a different perspective, a different approach, and I think it'll help us. It'll help these young group of guys that we're coaching right now.
Well, Coach, I guess there's really nothing else to say besides good luck Thursday night on a short week against the Sparklers. You've really painted yourself in a corner, and I hope we can get the hell out of it, and you can finally get back to the postseason.
All right. All right, guys. Have a good one.